In turfgrass water conservation, we're not only looking at applying potable water or water in drinking quality, tap water, if you want to call it that way, and how we can reduce that amount of water. We're also shifting to new types of waters, mainly saline groundwater, treated effluent, or recycling water. These are all waters that come with a higher salinity level. So now having, in the future, having grasses available that can tolerate higher salt concentrations with the water and in the soil will become very important, paramount to keeping green grass in urban settings. And therefore, we need to screen for salt tolerance in addition to screening for drought tolerance towards new grasses. The latest and newest, at least in turfgrass efficiency, would be subsurface irrigation and subsurface strip irrigation in particular. Even though it's not new in general, it has been used in agriculture for decades. It's kind of just now making some inroads also in turf irrigation. And subsurface strip irrigation is the only irrigation system that limits irrigation to exactly the area that also needs to be irrigated. So you have few to no losses and you have a much higher irrigation efficiency. The project in Albuquerque, the park irrigation system for the park in Albuquerque, is a partnership between industry, the Toro company, between the city of Albuquerque, the Parks and Rec Department, and NMSU, represented by the Extension Service. Well, the project in Albuquerque was interesting from the perspective that we were able to scale up our research findings, or to take our research findings to an area that is larger as the traditional residential turf area or even test plots. We've been showing over the last 10 years on test plots and also on the residential turf that subsurface strip irrigation works fine, and we have a higher water use efficiency. We apply water conservation, but we were not able to scale it up to larger areas. And this was the first project that a real world project that we could go out, take a park, split it in half, keep one half sprinkler irrigated, the other half will receive subsurface drip irrigation, and hopefully over the next 3 to 5 years we can prove our hypothesis correct that subsurface drip irrigation helps significantly in conserving irrigation water.
Eye on Research is a production of New Mexico State University.